At first glance, this seems like a regular chaotic day in the gym. Add some barrel rolling, aerial stunts, acrobats, stilt walking, and overall clowning around, and you have yourself a Green Fools Circus Camp. The Green Fools Theater Company is a traveling theater group that encourages and provides kids with the opportunity to run away to the circus. Jeffrey Olenek, an instructor with Green Fools, provided us with some information about the company.
Green Fools are a nonprofit theater organization. We specialize in physical theater, mask, clown, circus, produce shows. Been around for 30 years now. I think our 30th anniversary is coming up. Dean Barham is one of the co-artistic directors and based out of Calgary.
With this being the largest group to participate in Circus Camp, about 60 students in total, it's clear to see this is a favorite amongst the students. Diane Basandowski, a teacher who helps run the camp, let us in on why it's so important to have Circus Camp here in Chetwynd.
Circus Camp is important in Chetwynd because it changes kids' lives. Circus Camp is available to all kids. We like to provide equal access, and it's outside of the box. It's something different than what we might normally bring in. A lot of communities don't have Circus Camp, so it's really outside of the box, very different type of physical activity for kids to engage in.
We got the chance to talk to a few circus proteges and ask about their favorite things in circus camp.
My favorite part is doing the stilts, because they're really fun to walk in.
That's awesome.
And you can do fun tricks in, like some people can play soccer in them.
The rolly things over there.
Yes.
Probably just being here and kind of playing around and being able to do stuff like this.
I love the acro and the aerial, because I just feel strong when I do it.
Jaden, who's attended circus camp for about 5 years, explained why she wanted to be a mentor in the first place.
I was mentored last year, and I really liked helping the kids do new things that they've never done before, and it was really fun, so I tried it again.
Watching a child's confidence grow when they attempt something completely out of their comfort zone and succeed in it is always a moment for pride. Not only for the child, but the instructor as well. It's one of the greatest parts to his job, according to Jeffrey.
Two things. I really love just being in this atmosphere. It's fun, lots of good energy. But I also really love seeing a kid like get it for the first time. Like, we had little Nathan, and he was on stilts, he was so scared. And then he started walking, and he let go of his mom, and he was doing it on his own, and his face just lit up, and he was so happy. And it's really awesome to see a kid like succeed for the first time. It's something they don't think they can do. I love it.
With the circus camp being such a big success, one wonders where the idea first came to allow students to become circus performers. Diane explained where the idea came from and why it's since stuck around.
Circus camp was brought to Chetwynd by Marcy Fafanoff and Steffi Aykroyd 15 years ago. They were in Peace River, and there were some kids on stilts, and that's when they were first exposed to the circus camp idea. And so they contacted Green Fools Theatre in Calgary and brought circus camp to Chetwynd that year. And it's just evolved, and it keeps going. And Marcy and Steffi wanted to make it available to anybody, so they always kept the cost low. So kids get to be part of camp either free or $20 for the week. And I think that's something that I'm very passionate about, to make sure that all kids have access to it. So sort of like their legacy, we're making sure that all kids have opportunity.
The kids are given 4 days to prepare a performance that is put on for the entire town, and it allows them to show off their new skills they learned while being away at the circus. With the amount of time and effort the kids put into their performances, it's amazing to watch the growth from where they started to where they finished. Of course, all good things must come to an end, so we had to ask what they would miss most.
All the instructors and the people and clowning.
I'm gonna miss about unicycle and tightrope.
Yeah, I'm definitely gonna join it next year.
Whether you're an acrobat, a clown, stilt or tightrope walker, a barrel roller, or an aerialist, it's clear to see that Green Pools not only provides a fun getaway for the kids, but also an incredible opportunity to allow them to step out of their ordinary life of a student and become the circus performer they never knew they could be.
Well, it's too bad, and it's too sad, but I'm in love with you. Just love me, oh darling, love me. What can I do? I'm still in love with you. I guess I'll never see the light. I stay alone most every night since I fell for you. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone, and enjoy the performance.
Okay. I'm going to turn this on. Yep. We're switching mics.
All right. Thank you, everyone. Hello. Welcome. Glad you could join us. My name is Jeff. I am an instructor with Green Fools Theater Society. And for the past number of years, we've been coming up here to Chetwynd and doing this circus camp. Although this group that we have for this week is a lot of new faces. So this is the first time we've had this particular group of campers together. And in just 4 short days, they've been able to build a pretty incredible showcase that we'd like to share with you. But we really couldn't have done it without the help of our volunteers, so thank you, volunteers. And and extra special thanks go out to our Big Top sponsors. I'm going to name them all, and then we'll clap for them, all right? So our sponsors this year, Big Top sponsors, were PRRD, the Chetwynd Community Arts Society, Lakeview, Pomeroy, and the Days Inn, Caribou Road Service, Sereris Murphy and Emma Back. A warm round of applause for all of them, please. And we've had actually a lot of community help to put this together. So I'd also like to thank CalTire, the Tansy Friendship Center, Soto First Nations, West Moberly First Nations, School District Number 59, the Little Giant Figure Skating Club, the Chetwynd Senior Secondary, Peace FM, Chetwynd Social Planning Society, Subway, the Chetwynd Public Library, Christie Parish, Crazy Beans Bistro, Simply Perfect Catering, the CSS Janitors, BJ's Pure Water, and the many, many grandmothers who cooked for us. So warm round of applause for all them, please. So like I say, we've got a great showcase for you, but the main word in that is show. I'm going to get off this microphone, and we're going to start with our first act, which is our acrobats.
Cannonball guy just lost his job. His career was just taking off when he got fired. Bang, just like that. They'll never find another man of his caliber. Here's the aerial with Summer, Avea, Shirley, and Heidi.
Something new, see
Awesome. So we take you from up in the sky to down on the ground. Let's bring out our first set of clowns. Thank you.
All right, I'm the dub here for Peace FM and CHET TV, talking to icons of KISS who just finished up their set at GrizzFest 2017. How is it to play a festival as opposed to, say, an arena or a small venue like this, would you say, guys? Is there a lot of differences?
I would say that it's more fun for us, especially for all ages shows. It's fun to have the kids out, and it's just a lot of fun to share the bill with other bands. It's great.
So it's like a musician sort of a camaraderie, you know, with other bands especially. So
the heat sucks. Yeah. But it's a nice day. People especially are having a great time.
Yeah.
Cool. Have you guys played in the Peace before, this region of North British Columbia? No?
No. I haven't.
We played Sun Peaks a couple of times and festivals around that area, but this is the farthest north that we've gone into BC, and we're loving it out here.
Beautiful
country.
Here. Absolutely. Looking for some bears, as usual.
Actually, I'm looking to avoid the bears, but whatever floats his boat, right?
Are you going to have any time for sightseeing while you're here, or are you on to the next thing right away?
I pretty much have to leave right away tomorrow.
Yeah.
Tomorrow morning, we've got a long road back, so...
And where are you off to next? What's next on the schedule for you guys?
We're in Edmonton at the Century Casino on the 26th, I believe. And then the Deerfoot Casino in Calgary. And things are picking up. Got some things happening.
Well, thanks so much for doing this, guys. I really appreciate it. And congratulations on the rest of your tour.
Appreciate it.
All right.
I'm the dub for Peace FM. We'll be right back after this.
All right. So let's rock and roll all night, party every day. Show us everything you've got. You keep on dancing till the room gets hot. You drive us wild, we'll drive you crazy. And you say you wanna go for a spin. The party's just begun, we'll let you in. You drive us wild, we'll drive you crazy. You keep on shouting, you keep on shouting.
Send them back to get cleaned up, and we'll roll on out our next group. We've got our Barrel Walkers.
Kinda hard. And this ain't no place to be.
Come on.
Did you guys hear about the circus fire? It was intense. Next up, we have aerialists.
Adrenaline moving through my veins.
Applause. Now, why did the clown eat a dollar bill? Because it was her lunch money. Next up is Unicycles with Ireland, Kendra, and Clay.
Cyclists, head on to the front and take a much-deserved big bow.
We start very basic. We do lots of edges and three turns and just basic skills, and then work up into the more interesting stuff, I guess the kids would call it, more of the intricate spins and jumps. So we kind of do a bit of everything with them.
I'm doing doubles, so that's like a higher jump, and then just like spins and footwork and stuff, yeah.
What's the hardest part about those?
Definitely the double loop.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Why?
Because you have to go up on one foot and do two rotations in the air and then land on the same foot.
Whoa.
weren't those unicyclers great? So how do you win a circus fight? You go for the juggler. And now for something completely different.
Awesome work, jugglers. Give us your big finale trick. Finale trick. And take a bow. You did great. Nice work, everyone.
Wasn't that great? Why do clowns wear loud socks? Keep their feet from falling asleep. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, prepare to be amazed with the strongest clown ever, Zeus! We're gonna need some audience volunteers. Zeus, ready the ropes? We're gonna be having a tug of war against the strongest clown ever. Grab a piece of the rope. Grab a piece of the rope. Next up, we have our aerialists.
Take me by the hand. Beautiful. Joke for you today. I was just offered a job as a clown, and my new boss said the other guy was really good. So I have some really big shoes to fill. And up next, we have some Emma and Abby doing Tight Wire.
Stage crew is going to get cleaned up here, but we're going to bring out some more clowns.
Yeah.
again.
Dog goes.
Fish goes,
bubble up, bubble up.
Cat goes, open that can.
Meow, meow, open that can.
Cat goes, open that can.
Meow, meow, open that can.
Cat goes, open that can.
I enjoy using my imagination lots, and pretty much you can create anything. Like, there's no instructions to follow or anything.
Go on, get out of here, you crazy clowns. Get out. Take your time. Next up, we've got some incredible dancers. We hope they're going to make you into a believer.
I gained a little weight. What did the egg say to the clown? You crack me up. What did the clown say to the egg? Yolk's on you.
Next up, our aerialists.
If you catch me at the border, I'll go visit them tonight. If you come around, hey, I'll make them all day. I get one.
forget to quit cooking that game. Everyone's a winner, we're making our fame. Bonafide hustler, making my name. Sometimes I think sitting on trains. Every step I get to quit cooking that game. Everyone's a winner, we're making our fame. Bonafide hustler, making my name.
Yeah, I got more records than the KGB. So, no funny business.
Are you already off?
Some of them are murder. Some of them are like girls. Some of them are murder. Some of them are like girls.
I was looking through the paper and I saw an ad that said, wanted, acrobat. I thought, perfect, I can do that standing on my head. Speaking of which, give a warm welcome to the acrobats.
Wherever you want, get excited, you wanna steal.
cool.
Which circus performers see the best at night? The acrobats. Why don't cannibals eat clowns? Because they taste funny. Why did the clown cross the road? To get his rubber chicken. Clown held the door for me the other day. I said to myself, what a nice jester. The nice swallower finally solved his cholesterol problem. He stopped swallowing butter knives. I got hit by a clown car. Luckily, there was 23 people that got out to help. And time for the stilts.
Walkers, take a well-deserved bow. We've got one last thing for you. Let's bring everyone out. This is the entire cast of the Chetwynd Circus Showcase. Everyone out to the center. Hands together. Put your hands together. Put your hands nice and high. And take a bow. All right, everyone. I'm going to sneak my way through with the microphone cord. Hopefully not trip any stillwalkers. Thank you again. Thank you so much for joining us today. Did you have a good time? Did you have a good time? Wonderful. Well, that's why we come here. We just want to have a lot of fun and teach some circus to these kids. But we've got, I think, a special presentation. We've got a special Kara. Yeah. Oh, she needs just a second. What we probably need is like a really... Oh, there she is.
Y ahora, el hombre más famoso. Hi. We have a couple thank yous to do right now. Once my husband gets back with the other stuff. We had all of the kids and everybody here sign cards for all of the instructors and for Diane for always making this happen for us. Here is your cup that we got you.
You surprised me.
I know. Rebecca. I'll give you your cards first. This is from all of us.
Wow.
Thank you so much. It was such a pleasure to be in this community. You guys have such a fantastic community and really wonderful children. It was an honor and a privilege that I got to work with everyone here. Thank you.
I also have one for Sylvan. That's from all of us here.
Thank you. You have amazing kids, guys. Thanks.
Jeff. I got your name.
Thanks. Thanks so much, everyone. Pleasure to be here. Can't wait to come back.
And Mike. Love seeing you come here. There will be something when he gets back. But yes, that's from everybody. Everybody signed it. And
thank you very much,
it. Everybody.
I think I'm going to get my stilters down because I think their feet are killing them. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
That's it from us at Chetwynd Circus Camp. We hope you come back next year. Tell your friends, tell your mom, tell your friends' mom, and we'll see you again next year. Thanks, everyone.
For loitering and being bald. It's all for a good cause, for charity, for Cops for Cancer. And I think this is a wonderful thing, and I'm glad that I had the time to partake. And we raised $300 today for my bail to get me out, and I think this is great, and I hope to see more of it in the future.
Counselor for the District of Chetwynd. I was thrown in jail today on what I feel was a trumped up charge, and I think I was framed, but apparently it was for being the silliest dad in Chetwynd. I was put in jail by my daughter, who kind of forgets the fact that I feed her, and this is a choice of mine. But we got lots of money raised for cops for cancer. It's going directly towards kids who should never have to deal with such a thing, an awful thing. So just to make stuff easier on them, I think it goes towards a lot of good causes, treatment, research, and a lot of stuff like camps and stuff to help them cope through a difficult time like I say, that they shouldn't have to be dealing with at all. So happy to help.
RCMP and BC take part in. What we do is we have riders that go across the province in multiple jurisdictions raising money and awareness for cancer and specifically with the kids. Every dollar that we spend goes towards fundraising events such as getting new equipment down at Children's Hospital. We're also providing money for Camp Good Times. Behind me are two individuals that have already been arrested. They were nominated by friends and co-workers, and they're being asked to raise their bail, which is the fundraising part of it.
They got bailed out.
Ms. Waldy was arrested for apparently not drinking enough while she's doing payroll, and she is desperately trying to raise her $1,000 of bail. Previously, we had another member, Mr. Clay Bazandowski. He was arrested for being the silliest dad alive in Chetwynd. He's just made his bail, so he was released as per the agreement. This is a event that the community always comes around. Every 2 years, the riders come through Chetwynd when we do the north to south ride. This year, they're doing it in reverse, though. They're going to be coming up from Williams Lake all the way up to Dawson Creek, and they'll be here September 16th in Chetwynd. The ride starts in September down in Williams Lake, and the riders are approximately a 30-person team right now, and they'll be the ones coming up, and we'll be greeting them also in Chetwynd and having events closer to the time when they're actually here.
I work at High Sky Enterprises Limited, which is a family-run company which was established in 1981. We are log contractors and coal haulers. I got arrested for not drinking enough wine while I do payroll, which is true. I don't actually drink while I do payroll, maybe after. My bail was set for $1,000. I didn't think that that was feasible. I didn't know that I had $1,000 worth of friends, but the community comes together to support the fight for cancer, and I appreciate the small businesses that I reached out to bail me out. It's a great cause, and cancer affects our small community, because everybody seems to know everybody. So I appreciate the donations, and thanks for bailing me out of jail.
I am Jennifer Brake. I am the manager of the Coffee Talk, and I was arrested by my husband, who's still in jail here behind me, desperately trying to raise money for cops for cancer. My bail was $500, and I was arrested apparently for just looking too good. I raised my $500 thanks to my family and my coworkers in about 15 minutes. So it's a good cause, this Cops for Cancer. It affects a lot of people in our community, so I'm glad to be here to support it.
Linda Morgan from Peace FM. I'm the afternoon drive announcer, and I'm new to town. I'm from Toronto, and I was just arrested because apparently one of my coworkers thinks that I'm weird, I get excited too easily, and I drink too much. And so I am here at the Chetwynd Lakeview Credit Union. This is the rolling jail and bail wagon. I just got out. Here are my cellmates here. And some of them need as much as $500 in order to get bailed out of jail. So yeah, and all of the money raised is going to Cops for Cancer. If you spend at least $500 to bail them out, your name's going to be put into a draw for some awesome box seats for the Bob Dylan concert. The tickets have all been donated by Peter's Brothers Paving. And come on down here and help us out for a good cause.
I was arrested for forgetting stuff at work, and appreciate all the money that everyone donated to help bail me out of jail and for the great cause, cancer research.
And I'm out here in front of the credit union in Chetwynd for Cots for Kids. We're doing a jail and bail charity event. Behind me we have two individuals that were sponsored by people in the community. And the gentleman on my left was arrested for attempting to fix a hot water tank and pretty well drained his whole house of water. And the lady on my right, her name is Myra, and her husband nominated her because she was a great partner to work with, and he loves her tons. So they're in jail until they reach their bail amount money. And we've allowed them to have access to their cell phones in order to raise that kind of money. So Cops for Kids is a charity event that the RCMP and other police forces around Canada help promote the fight against cancer for children. We have our junior member right here, Chase. Do you want to come over here, bud? Every community has a junior member that is a hallmark for the RCMP members that ride their bikes throughout BC. And this year, the bikes are going to be coming into Chetwynd and making their way into Dawson and Highway 97 and up to Hudson Hope and all those great places. So each community will have their chance to donate funds and help raise awareness for cancer, especially for these little guys here.
Yeah. Science World is a charitable organization, and our entire mission is to engage British Columbians across the province in different kinds of science. So the On the Road program is internally funded, and it's an outreach program to reach schools in British Columbia that may not get the chance to take a field trip to Science World very often, or that might not get to visit at all. So depending on the size of the school, we have a primary show for kindergarten to grade threes, which is about the scientific process. It's called How to Science. We have an intermediate show called Earth, Wind and Science, which is about the weather. And then we have an entire school show for smaller schools called Fantastic Forces, which talks all about forces such as push and pull, lift and friction.
You also talked about your grandchild.
That's right.
And that's Molly.
So when you have a granddaughter who has music in her, from the time she was born, she had music in her, she inspires a story. And this looks quite a bit like her. And put a piano in front of her, put a set of drums, put a tambourine, or just stand her there, she'll sing, "This girl makes music." So she inspired me to write Molly's Promise.